Hey, it's Clay Chart, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol BTSC. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes worth of time. So while this here may look like several days, it's actually just today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like to do this time frame. I think that's a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price. And then just makes mapping out where levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. I've been doing this analysis on a routine basis, including yesterday. So that is where the green and red line annotations are coming from. And after today's crazy price movement, definitely want to get some updates here made, going forward. Just a crazy day for Bitcoin in general. So it's not shocking to see that a Bitcoin stock also had a crazy day. So what I'm going to do here is, yeah, this line right here still pertains to the chart, but I want to really try to simplify this as there's two key levels that in my mind really stand out right now as pertaining to the future of the chart. And this first one is where the buyers truly do seem to be hanging out in quite a bit of authority, and that's down there at the 28 cent mark. Why is 28 cents quite the historic level now at this point in time? Well, it started off as a clue here. Last time the price had a crazy pulled back, and then right there at 28 cents found support before bouncing. Fast forward to today with the crazy pullback, and surprise, surprise, look right where the price decided to once again bounce, right there at 28 cents. So clearly there are buyers, there are people that are very interested in buying the stock down at 28 cents whenever it gets down there. Now, are they going to stay down there at that level? A chart's not going to tell you that, but what it's telling us right now is that, yeah, there is people down at 28 cents that want to buy. So if the price were to get back down there again, it's not irrational to think, maybe that'll bounce from there again, because there is now past history of it bouncing. So 28 cents, definitely that key level of support. On the flip side of things, as I talked about in yesterday's video, then you have the key level of resistance, and that sits up here at the 46 cent mark, which going through the history, you can see, and I pointed this out yesterday, but I want to point it out again, because again, you fast forward, and after the price fell below it right there, you can see once again, price tried to get up above it, and it temporarily got up above it, but couldn't sustain it and fell right back below it. So going into pretty much the rest of this week now, there's tomorrow and then Friday. These are going to be the two key levels. Key level of resistance, 46 cents. Key level of support, 28 cents. Maybe you're thinking, holy smokes, that's a wide range. Well, welcome to the world of penny stocks. Welcome to the world of Bitcoin. Sometimes these ranges can get quite volatile. But it is what it is right now. So those would be the two key levels that I would keep an eye on. So we'll see what happens with it. One of the biggest questions that I get is, hey Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.